This is the demo session on Cisco Prime. Now, Cisco Prime is one of the premium controller from Cisco. It's a premium software that is capable of visualizing the network, visualizing the application. Apart from the visualization, we can implement, means we can configure different type of wired and wireless devices with the help of Cisco Prime. Here you can see I listed six scenario. So apart from this dashboard and the network visibility feature, we can have different options related to service enforcement. We can configure n number of devices. We can have report. Now, this report is very different to the normal report that we can have report related to device end of life, end of hardware, end of software. Apart from that, any vulnerability or PSIT, such type of things we can get from this report section. Plus, we have 360 degree visualization for the devices. So one by one, I will go through all these tasks. Let me log to the Epic. So before logging this, how we can book a slot in vCloud? You have to use this name. Once you use this name, then you will get such type of reservation where you can use vCloud credentials like this. This is for any connect. This is username and password. So your any connect means your tunnel is established. Once your tunnel is established, you have to RDP to the workstation. So where you can RDP, I'll show you that workstation detail. Here you can see workstation, the IP address is 133.36. Here I already RDP. So once you RDP, you will get this URL here, 198.18.134.53. This is for Prime. Apart from that, here you can see you have access to other devices as well, that we have WLC, we have ICE as well. So we have other devices also. We can log in and we can play around. What username and password we can use, that is a bit tricky here. If you go to the PPT that I already shared, here you can see the different devices and what username and password we can use. So this Prime infrastructure, they are telling use username as a session owner and password as a session ID. Now what is that? So once you registered, you have to click here at the info section, and from there this owner is the user ID and 41822 is the password. Let me re-verify that what is the password. 41822. Login. Four one eight two two network. Yeah, 41822 was the password. Once you log in, you'll get this type of dashboard. This dashboard is very different because we have already discussed Live NX and Cisco Epic. If you compare with those dashboard, this is different dashboard. Here, if you go to the root, this section I just highlighted here, there is a setting sign. If I click to that, let me click there, and I can use this dashboard, this setting as my desktop type of setting. So whenever I open Prime, this dashboard will come. Okay, let me click here. See, set current page as home. So whenever I logged in, this page will come. Home page setup is successful. Here at the bottom, you'll get that message. What is important here in the Prime, because this is a graphical tool. You click here at the home button. I just clicked in at the home button. You can see we have various options. So we have options related to dashboard, monitor, configure, inventory, maps, service, report, administration. Now all these options, if you go one by one to all these options, you will find it's very self-explanatory. Means if you want to configure anything, obviously you have to go to configure. If you want to check your inventory list, you have to go to inventory. If you want to check application services plus IWAN services, you have to go to services. Suppose if I click here in the services, in the service option, you can see network services. We have IWAN, converged access, instant access, guest users. There are lots of plugins related to mobility service. You can see here. Apart from that, this section is also very, very important. This application and visibility section. So in this application and visibility section, things are very much related to IWAN, like NBAR2, PFR monitoring, application visibility control, interface configuration is normal, application troubleshooting is also very normal, link monitoring. Nowadays we are getting lots of things related to link, media net, netflow, again related to IWAN or non-IWAN as well. But there are lots of plugins, lots of new things related to IWAN. Then the service health rule, etc. So this service tab is really very important. Let me show you the other tab, that is the reports. Then one by one I'll go to each and every. In report you can see here PSIRT and EOX. EOX X stand for either S or H, end of hardware or end of software. Various services that we can fetch from here. So let me go first to the dashboard. Let me click to the dashboard and then the overview. I clicked here in the dashboard and overview. Here there are lots of interesting things that we can discuss. In the metrics section, it is telling that what are the devices are unreachable with respect to ICMP, with respect to SNMP, means you know the monitoring and the ping are failing for those devices. Then with respect to access points, let me scroll down. I'll go to all these devices one by one. What branches you have, what APs you have, what are the top talkers, what are the interfaces which is heavily utilized, what is your network topology. Obviously, one by one you can go inside all these things, but this is the general dashboard view here. In this particular dashboard view, if I scroll little bit down, and you can see here that these blue things, I can take report for different time frames. For top N CPU utilization, if I click here, I can go inside that report and I can fetch which particular is the heavily utilized devices. You can see here top n CPU. So what is the CPU utilization at what time frame, memory utilization, interface utilization, top n interfaces, all these things actually we are fetching reports for our client, that with help of Cisco Prime we have single software or controller from where we can get reports for all the devices across the data center. That is the power of this. Now I'm going back. If you want to go to home, you can click this Cisco sign. This is the home button. Click here. This is the home that we have saved. Let me click here to the unreachable, because it is showing that two devices are unreachable. Click here. And one very important note I'm giving here, that this is the path actually. In the Linux world also, if you want to go inside inventory, so inside one folder, inside folder, inside folder, then inside that folder, this is something like that. So at the moment we are inside inventory, inside device management, inside device network devices. Okay. Now what I can do here, I can click to this and this. So once you check these two devices which are unreachable, say if I uncheck this mark, you can see sync is disabled, group export, all these things are disabled. If I check these boxes, now sync is enabled. Click sync. Once you click sync, what is it telling? Device syncs may take some time, you will need to refresh. Okay, I want to sync it and it will take some time, so I'll return back. But suppose again, if you want to go to the home page, what you have to do, just click here in the Cisco. That is the first option. Otherwise, click here at the menu tab. In the menu tab, once you click to the menu tab, it will give you option that where you want to go. You want to go to dashboard, monitor, configuration, etc. So let us focus on dashboard itself. In dashboard, although there are various options here like overview, incident, again this is also very important. I'll come to this point, that is the incident. I'll come to the that point. Before moving forward, let me tell you something important here. Okay. Now we are studying two flavors of SD-WAN. One is the IWAN and other one is Viptela. Both are doing almost the same thing, but both are, you can say, the different type of implementation. What is similarity in both the cases? That similarity, that if you see this particular diagram, I'll share this. This is a very rough one. Actually, this portion is data center one. This portion is DC 2. So theoretically we have same size, same type of data center irrespective of client. Whatever client we have, they have primary and the backup data center. They may have tertiary, but they have primary and secondary data center. Then they have some edge devices, and then they have some you can say customer edge, and then somewhere provider edge devices. Means they have some ISP1 and ISP2. In our case, suppose this is MPLS and internet, no problem. One link is going here, one is here, then here, and then here. So what I try to tell here, that irrespective of IWAN, this side I am using IWAN, this side I am using Viptela, because these are the software defined network, so we need controller. In case of IWAN, we need Epic EM, we need Cisco Prime, and for better network visualization and the application visualization, we need LiveNX. Now, the same is true with Viptela. Instead of Epic EM and Cisco Prime, we have single managed device. Are you able to hear? Okay.
Yes, Ratnesh, you're able to hear.
Okay, thanks.
Vinay here.
Okay, Vinay, yeah, thanks. Yeah. So here
Yes.
in Viptela world, we have something called vManage. So vManage is a controller which is doing the task whatever we can do with the Epic EM and the Cisco Prime. In Viptela world also we have LiveNX. So it is unchanged. It is present both the places. Then in Viptela world we have something called vSmart. It is reserved only for the policies. Policies, then app-aware routing, and the application visibility control (AVC). Okay. You can see here that how the technology is overlapping. If we check Epic EM, that we have already done the session on that. Epic EM has four. Cisco Prime is also a management device, so we can think this as a Cisco managed software or controller, where we can do all type of configuration, irrespective of wired or wireless. Plus, it has lot many features. So Cisco Prime, it's very much analogous to vManage. vManage also you will see in coming days that in vManage also we can pull different type of reports, and vManage can be clubbed with the cloud. So there is one option, cloud inside vManage. Cisco Prime, I don't think so any option with respect to cloud, but in Cisco there are other options that we can integrate with the cloud. So what I try to tell here, that here we have Epic and Cisco Prime, and in Viptela we have vManage and vSmart. So in this space, Cisco is doing their SD-WAN solution with respect to IWAN and with respect to Viptela. Maybe in future they will merge both the technology, so we don't need to learn all these stuffs. We'll learn only one thing, but at the moment we have to understand all these things. Going back to Cisco Prime, let me go back to Cisco Prime here. I was here in the dashboard. Inside dashboard, we have these options. You will get this side thing in Viptela as well. Obviously, devices, it may be your device or the branch side device. Your means your data center device or branch device. This is the unique feature in Cisco Prime. Cisco Prime is very, very much supported with WLCs. There are n number of things that we can do with help of Cisco Prime with respect to WLC. Then the interfaces are interfaces, applications running over the interfaces, video and voice, all these things. So let me click to one or two things. So let me click here in the incident, because remember, this Cisco Prime is the management tool where we can have different type of management reports. reports related to bandwidth, router reboot, utilization memory, plus this incident. So far, say it's 9 critical incidents are here. If you click here, it will let you go inside monitoring tools, alarms, alarm event and the alarms. Here, if you click to this, you'll get to know when it generates that alarm. And if you click here, this portion, it will give you the detail about that alarm. So why this alarm is there? Backplane 0/3 value of interface, outbound discard, violating some input output packet drops are there. Like that, we can check the incident report. Again, I'm clicking to dashboard, and the in dashboard we have site summary, network health. So now you may have a rough idea of that what this dashboard is doing. It will give you overview of incident or site or network health and these things. Now let me click to the monitor. Monitoring, we have different type of monitoring alarms. Let me go to the configuration. And this is simple demo just to show you what options we have with the Prime. I already shared document related to this, where in the configuration, there are some configuration related to WLC, that if you want, you can do it. Whatever main important thing here that I'm highlighting here. The dashboard, this PNP feature we have already discussed with respect to Epic EM. So in Epic EM, they are using the PNP in terms of Viptela, they are telling zero touch provisioning. So that should be Z zero touch provisioning, ZTP. In Cisco, they are using this PNP name. In Viptela, it is zero touch provisioning. Means suppose in branch, you want to configure a branch. You don't want to touch the router. Simply you plug the device and it will take the IP address. It will take all the configuration and it will be functional. So this feature here, PNP inside configuration, that in a branch, we can plug the device and it will work. I'm focusing here in this profile, jobs and policy. This policy is again very important because nowadays it's very difficult to understand all different variants inside SD-WAN, IWAN and Viptela. So what we can do, we can correlate these things. So here we have policies. Even in the Live NX also we have policies, and even in the Epic EM also we have policies. These are the predefined policies. If we want, we can go inside policy and we can apply this policy. Means we can attach this policy to a branch or to a data center. It's like that. So you just check my PPTs where I checked one policy and I apply that policy. But from here, you can go to the policy. If you want, you can edit it. There in the PPT, I scroll through next. Here you can see what are the things that you can do. Rule information, platform section, then rule input. So if I just click next, it will pop up. Which devices I can use this rule? What action this rule will do? And what is the condition and action with this rule? Yeah. make sure that all V2I line blocking incoming connection. So this is the rule you can apply. It's a pre-built rule, you can apply it to anywhere. Okay, and it's very important to understand the path, configuration, compliance, and then policy. Let me go back to the configuration. Let me click here to the network device once. Let me select any of the device here, but if you know which branch, is it a router or switch or AP, what you want to configure, randomly let me check this switch, China LAN. I can simply double click here. It is loading. The same type of feeling you will get when you will navigate via vManage. Inside vManage also we can SSH to various devices across the data center, and we can do the configuration. Here we have option that we can change the configuration with help of this graphic interface. There may be some problem with this device. Let me choose some other device which is already there. Let me choose this one. Do one thing, let me select it and scroll here. Supported. Okay, likewise we can have different options that you can configure this device. Okay. So what I have done so far, I just clicked on dashboard. We check what is the option there in the dashboard. You please refer the PPT and I'll share the document as well. Monitor, configuration. Inventory is very much self-explanatory, that will get the list of all the devices. If you want to check what is the geographic location of all the devices across globe, you can use this maps option. This is also there in the vManage. These two things are very important for management purpose. Services and reports. So let me click on these two and then we'll finish the session. Let me click here to services. In services you can see here IWAN enablement. So I'm going to conduct one session on IWAN, actually 5-6 sessions on IWAN, where from scratch I am going to build a lab. I'll show you what type of lab I'm going to build. This lab I'm going to build where I'll configure all the devices. So these devices, like these data center devices, then these branch devices, everything I'm going to configure it. Here I will run DMVPN as an overlay protocol. And then I'm going to use Cisco Prime, Epic EM and Live NX to full functioning this environment. Okay, so on that day, I'll show you that what is the use of this particular IWAN enablement. But it's easy. Once you click there in the services and then the IWAN, it will let you through this particular area where one by one you have to walk through. Then you have to choose the configuration, then you have to select the devices, then you have to give the input option, then it will give you the summary, and finally you have to implement. Okay, so this I am going to cover in the separate portion in the upcoming IWAN full-fledged series, that where we have access to all the devices and we'll do via CLI in the coming days. Let me just show you the other option in the services. One option is the IWAN option, and inside IWAN you can see these four important features. These are really very important: DMVPN, application visibility control, quality of service, and performance routing. These four builds IWAN core. That we'll see that. Again, let me click to the services. There are other options that we have: NBAR, PFR. So once we have full-fledged IWAN running, we can use these things. Let me click here to the application and services. Once you click to the application services, you can see the list of various type of services. Here you have the filter as well. Suppose if you type a yes, then you will get, let me just show you what is this. This is the business critical application. So I am seeing all the business critical applications, and I click here. Just if you want to select, suppose I select this. Let me deselect first. So it is showing that what application is it? What are the attributes with respect to this application? If you want to change something, is it a business critical? So check mark is there. If you want, you just uncheck it, check it, you can update, and behind the scene it is updating that. Yeah, so all this business app visibility we'll see in the IWAN, and even this this visibility we have with the help of live action. So in the live action we have different coloring or tag parameters where we can visualize with respect to application or with respect to DHCP marking, or there are so many other options to visualize. But from here also we can check that business applications. Okay, and finally we have this reports. I'll show you this one only, that the PSIT and EOX, PSIRT. See, with respect to all the devices, we have these things. So device PSIRT, device hardware end of life, software end of life, and the field notice. Now, a good thing here, suppose this particular device, if I double click, it will let me to the field notice, this particular page it will. So I don't know why it is not coming. Yeah, once you click here, it will pop up new page, and that new page has the information about that particular field notice. So let me just quickly check this feature here. Why it is Here you have the URL. Okay, so you have to go here, click here, it will open new page where you have detail about that will notice. Okay. So you can see that it will obviously save our time. Even if a particular device has reached end of software support, so here you can see 2014 end of sale, end of support, what OS, when it is going to be end, all this information about the hardware as well, or end of life, this device has end of life, all details about that. This is the link, this is the URL where we will get the information about this. Then what about the vulnerabilities? Multiple vulnerabilities here. If I click here, you again pop up new page with respect to this particular switch 3650, and it will show the vulnerabilities of this particular device. Okay. This was a quick demo that what options we have with Cisco Prime. Yeah, this services I will come again in the IWAN section, where I will use this IWAN enablement. Apart from that, you can see that things are very much self-explanatory. If you just Google, you will get the full-fledged document with respect to Cisco Prime. And here